PanicAttackRecovery.com.
Hi, I'm Lynette from PanicAttackRecovery.com. We're a collaboration of former sufferers helping people with panic attacks, anxiety, stress, and ADHD. This is part two of our video series on letting go of the petty. In part one, we discussed how perfectionism can draw one into focusing on the petty. We also shared a suggestion to deal with perfectionism and one of the ways that you can train yourself to let go on more routine tasks. It's not easy at first to stop this tendency, so it does take practice. However, it's worth it in the long run because this can be very freeing. By not having your energy zapped by petty things, you can save your energy for those really important tasks that are going to require more effort, rather than hyper-focusing on things that simply don't need as much effort. We would suggest that the most helpful strategy to learn is to move away from loathing disapproval and instead better prepare for criticisms that are naturally going to arise in life from time to time. In other words, you simply anticipate some general criticisms and have a response that you feel would be adequate to the insult. How can you do this? Let me provide an example. You've worked on a particular project and someone criticizes your work, but overall, you know that your work is well received by people who benefit from your products. You could actually disarm the insult by thanking the person for sharing their opinion and feedback and indicating that you'll think about it. You're not lying and you're not being defensive. I'm not saying this is an easy process at first, but over time, you can change how you process such petty criticisms. At the same time, some people you interact with might have a very negative disposition and it's very hard to take their criticism. However, sometimes their feedback might have some merit. When you process things through the lens of doing what you feel is best with such feedback, your decision making can become less based on pleasing others and rather reflecting on whether you think the criticism warrants a change. I'd like to challenge you to try the suggestions in part one and two of this video series and to always be conscious of letting go of the petty. We think if you do these things, you will have much less stress and anxiety and focus more on those activities that bring you joy in life. Thank you for watching this video, and we look forward to presenting another one next week. For the extended version of the material presented in this video, you can listen to the podcast episode by visiting our website and subscribing to our free newsletter.
PanicAttackRecovery.com